You said it. You said it a million times. Don't go into business with Sonny Corinthos. And did I listen? No, of course not. No, because I have to be right. Heaven forbid. I mean, do you remember back when it was so nice? I mean, everybody was in love. Do you remember that? I mean, it was me and you, and it was Sonny and Brenda, and it was you and Brenda, and it was Lily and Miguel, and it was me and Sonny. I mean, it was a freaking love fest, you know? And we had created this way cool company. We had our own little functions, and every indication that we were having this majorly groovy situation happening. And now, the bloom is so far off the rose, it's practically sailing through the sky into another country, and I'm about ready to lose the home I'm killing. Okay, okay, here we go. I can't breathe again.
Okay, all right, stop talking. That's good. That's right, just breathe. There you go, honey, breathe. That's right. That's good. Breathe. Yes, good. There, that's good. Good girl.
You are so lucky that that doesn't happen to you.
Looks pretty scary. Are you all right?
Oh, yeah. I'm just great. I'm about to lose my company and all is right with the world.
Why are you being so pessimistic? It's not like you.
You'll forgive the lapse, I'm sure.
Sonny hasn't even been charged with anything yet. An investigation is not the worst thing that can happen.
Oh, no. It's just a prelude to the worst possible thing that can happen. In the meantime, we just gotta wait. I mean, heaven forbid, the axe should just go ahead and fall already. No, I mean, we just gotta sit there with it poised over our heads for the next few weeks and just wait for it to fall. In the meantime, we gotta go to Sonny one more time and bang our heads against that
brick
wall.
Lois, calm down. You're getting all excited again.
No.
Calm down.
I do not understand how he could be so mean. I would have never pegged him for this kind of betrayal.
Well, believe it or not, it's more about everyone else in the room than it is about you. Huh. It's about getting back at Brenda for wearing the wire. And Miguel, it's about power. And about wanting to get into my face. You're an afterthought. You're just a mere casualty. You don't get that, do you?
If that is supposed to make me feel better, I got news for you, okay?
I'm sorry. It's just that I get... Never mind. The point I'm trying to make is, even if the worst happens, it's still not that bad.
Okay, Mr. Optimist, I'm listening to you big time. So you explain to me how this scenario plays out in any way that doesn't spell disaster for L&B.
It is. Say Sonny is arrested, and L&B is frozen until the trial is over. How long can that last? 6 months tops. So we use it. We take a break and concentrate on long-term planning so we can hit the ground running when it's over.
What if Sonny is found guilty?
Well, then L&B is seized and it goes into government receivership.
No!
And then we can just buy it back. And if he's acquitted, well, if that's the case, then we just right back where we started, trying to force him out of L&B. See? It's not that bad.
What if Sonny is convicted? The government grabs L&B and they won't sell it back to us, huh? Or what if the government, if they auction it off and some big record honcho like Cepeda outbids us and we don't even know it? You know? I mean, government auctions, they could be secret, right? What happens if we eventually do find out and they won't sell it back to us, huh? I mean, what happens if it gets all snarled up in some bureaucratic red tape or it gets lost for crying out loud? What happens if your contract gets so tied up that you can never sing again, huh? Did you ever think of that? Oh, I should have listened. Oh, boy, I should have listened. Oh, boy.
Oh, boy. Whoa. That's right. Just breathe. Easy. There you go, girl. Sit down. That's good. Now listen to me. We have the resources. I will lend you whatever you need to match any bid. And if my contract disappears, hey, I'll just change my name and play the cabarets. A singer can sing anything.
gentlemen, the Gila Lizard Lounge is proud to present, for your listening pleasure, the song stylings of Nettie Payne.
Well, thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Whoa, sorry about that. You want to lower the volume a little? Thank you. Well, good evening. Good evening. How many of you guys out there have ever been in love? Well, welcome to the ranks. This one's for you, baby doll. You once, twice, three times a lady, and I love you. Yes, you once.
I'm so depressed. Oh.
Are you sure you're all right?
Yeah. See? Fortunately, there's too much work to have the proper nervous breakdown. I have to finish coordinating this New York photo shoot. Hey, you're not going to have any problem getting sprung from 9 to 5, are you?
I'll probably be a little late. I have a ton of stuff
guys.
To do at my desk. Hello.
You go. I'll tell her.
Tell me what?
See you later.
Wait a minute. Tell me what? What's going on?
Come over here and sit down.
No, I don't want to sit down. I'll stand. What?
Okay. All right, well, then I'm just going to come right out and say it. It seems that the feds and the cops have hit pay dirt on Sonny, and he may go down soon.
What do they have?
Some kind of financial paper trail. I don't know, whatever it is, it's pretty big. Are you with me so far? Okay, well, Ned and I went to go see Sonny and asked him again to let us buy him out. His answer was the same. So now L&B is at risk.
I hate this.
I'm with you.
You know, look, if you think it's a good idea, maybe I should go over and talk to Sonny about this. I know how to get through to him. If I caught him in a really good moment, maybe I could get him to change his mind. I mean, I... What am I saying? I'm delusional.
You know, I really don't think there's anything anybody can do right now. L&B's fate seems to be out of our control, which really sticks in my craw, I can assure you.
No, no, no. What about Edward? Edward!
What? Well, I went to him the first time we realized we needed to get Sonny out. But you know what? To tell you the truth, especially with the tear he's been on about Ned's involvement in L&B, he's probably going to think that this is a good thing.
No, he would not. Well, I mean, maybe for one selfish moment. No, I mean, you have to remember the big picture here. Your family, and Edward's crazy about us. You know, I mean, if anyone knows about this, Edward Quartermain has to know more about loopholes in business and government than anyone on the Eastern Seaboard, right? I mean, look, maybe Sonny's legal situation is in conflict with our agreement.
How so?
Well, I don't know. Doesn't the fact that Sonny could be prosecuted, doesn't that interfere with L&B's creative direction? Or something?
You're borderline genius. Yes! Yes! Oh, yes! Okay, you know what? Hold down the fort because I'm expecting a call from the photographer, okay?
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. I wish I knew what you were gonna do.
I think I could persuade him, but you know, there's Ned. And Sonny hates Ned. He loves to get in his face and push his buttons. And then, of course, there's Brenda and all the unresolved stuff between them. I know. I'm sorry. I'm rambling. I am. It's on account of all these panic attacks that I've been having all day long. But you know what? You know, if you could just do me a favor and just
think on this, I'd be ever so grateful, you know, in spite of the fact that you've been kind of annoyed with L&B lately.
Oh, posh. That means nothing, Lois, not when it comes to interlopers bringing trouble to one of my own. All other issues are transcended, for the moment.
Oh, Mr. Q, that is so sweet.
You are a Quartermain, and we take care of one another. Now, I'll put in a call to the mayor and see if I can find out a timetable. Once we learn how quickly the authorities are set to move, then I will consult my lawyer. So let's say that you can hear from me by midday tomorrow. Hmm?
Great. Hmm. Great. Oh, no. Ned and I are going to be in New York for a photo shoot. Oh, no. Brenda will be in the office all day long. I'll check in regular.
Excellent. Now, here, you go ahead and take care of your business and no more panic attacks.
Oh,
huh?
Thank you so much, Mr. Q. Thank you.
All right.
You're great.
You run along.
Okay, you're great.